Tickets, phone calls, chat requests, emails, doesn't matter what you call them, they all turn into incidents in your service desk. So let's go ahead and figure out how to work with them the most efficient way possible. So from your main dashboard, you want to go up to the hamburger menu and then select Service Desk, Incidents. All right, from jump, there's a whole bunch of incidents in here, but the beauty of it is you can filter these for what you need. In fact, the one I'm going to use today is all active incidents. You can see here, the state is just not closed, but you can add additional ones here, build ones for your specific group, for your specific team, or ones that are only assigned to you. But let's go ahead and open one of these cases. All right, so we'll take the first one here that's new and not assigned and has no category or subcategory. So it looks like Patrick's having problems with his Salesforce password, but we don't have a category or a subcategory. For me, I want to make sure that gets filtered in properly. So I want to select a category and it's applications. And the subcategory is Salesforce. Now that it's categorized, there's a couple things we can do. We can assign it to the appropriate team. In this case, if it should go to the Salesforce admin group, or we can just make notes and call out said team. When you @mention someone like that, they'll get a notification in the app, and if they're not in the app, they will get an email. One of the benefits of working in a service desk is you can actually go and connect these with related items. So you can connect this to other incidents, problems, changes, or configuration items, like a computer or a printer. In this case, it's pretty obvious this is a standalone issue, so let's go ahead and help this end user. We have reset their password, they are now in, so let's go ahead and flip the state to resolved. When you put a resolution in, you have to select the type. It is done. In this case, we just reset the password for the user manually. But if this is something that can be used for multiple users, you can create a solution. And we'll go ahead and resolve this case. One of the benefits of the system is the resolution will be right at the top, giving you an update so you don't have to go through the entire audit history. For the most part, if you know what the issue is, you don't even have to go into an incident. So we'll look at this case here, where it's a medium priority, and we've already breached a service level. So we can go ahead and kick up the priority. And since we know it's Salesforce again, we'll select Applications, Salesforce, and we'll kick it over to the Salesforce team. And that's it. Now it's assigned to them with a critical state. So that's a real quick overview of how, in a couple of clicks, you can handle most of your incident management, whether it is filtering your list or assigning categories or kicking it out to other teams. We just want to make sure you can handle the number of incidents you have in the most efficient way possible.